how can you use numbers in your speeches to help people understand a problem without confusing them? Well, the answer to that question will be found in this Daily Dose of Public Speaking Wisdom. You've heard about anecdotes and analogies to anchor your points to the audience. Well, there's a third kind you can use. It's called analytics or numbers. We have to be careful as speakers when we use numbers. I've heard presenters throw so many numbers up that I got confused fairly quickly, and I'm a numbers guy. As an example, I will hear speakers throw combinations of numbers out, and then I'm starting to do the math in my head, and while I'm doing math in my head, they keep talking. I've lost their point. Be judicious about how you use numbers. With that said, they can be beneficial. For example, when I talk to salespeople about using business stories in their presentations, I will tell them that my experience early on in my career was that when I incorporated business storytelling, I increased my number of new prospects by 287% in a 9-month period. Why did that statistic work? Mostly because I was specific about my numbers. I didn't say, oh, I about tripled my number of new clients, and it was about a year. When people use phrases like about or kind of like or some variation of those, it makes the number less believable. It feels like you just pulled it out of the air. When I can say 287% in 9 months, that lets people know that I've done my homework, I know my numbers, and it makes the numbers more believable. Also notice, I only used two numbers in that example. That's all I had to tell them. The audience will do the remainder of the math if you just give them a couple of numbers like that. They'll sit there and figure out what 287% means to them. They'll know the significance of 9 months to their practice, however their sales cycle works. Let them do the rest. So numbers can be important. Try to build a story around them and be specific. Do that, and you've got a good anchor that will better sell your message. Tomorrow you'll hear about the fourth and final anchor, which is activities. See you then.